In this video, I'll show you four different ways for how to add reflections to your designs like this in Adobe XD. Okay, I'm starting with a new artboard sized at 1920 by 1080 pixels. The first thing to do is to add text. Tap T on your keyboard to bring up the type tool, click and add some text. I'm using the vertical and horizontal align tools to center the text within the artboard. The typeface I'm using in this example is Poppins Bold. If you have the Adobe Creative Cloud subscription, then this typeface is included. You just need to go to Adobe Fonts and download it. I want the text to be in all caps, so click on uppercase and recenter it within the artboard. Next, we need to copy and paste this text, so Command C and Command V. And if you look over in the Layers panel, now you see that there are two different text layers. While pressing Shift, click and drag to move one of the layers until it snaps to the bottom of the other. Then use the Flip Vertical tool so that the text is now reflected. We want to change this bottom text from a solid color to a gradient. You'll notice that the gradient isn't an option when you click on the fill color. You can't add a gradient to live text, so we will have to outline it and make it into a shape. To do this, select the text, go to Object, Path, Convert to Path, or use the keyboard shortcut Command 8. And now each individual letter is its own shape. If you double click, you can see the individual anchor points. It's no longer live text. Now we can go over to Fill and choose Linear Gradient. You'll notice there are two circles, one for where the gradient begins and where it ends. We'll use the eyedropper tool to change the second color to the same as the text, so black. The difference is we want to change the opacity to 0%. Then we'll switch to the first color, and we want to keep it the same, but we want to adjust the opacity. This, of course, is up to you and how you like to create your reflections, but I'm going to create a more subtle reflection and maybe go somewhere around 45%. Another adjustment you can play around to your liking is how tall or short the full gradient is. Click on the bottom circle for the end of the gradient and pull it up to wherever you want your gradient to end. I'll keep mine to about a third of the height of the letters. And then you can go in and adjust your gradients. Still keep the bottom one at 0%. You can click on the other one and adjust the opacity to see if it creates a better effect. Maybe you want a darker, more dramatic reflection, or maybe you want it to be more subtle. So this is how you create a basic reflection with black text on a white background. Now let's try to create a color version. First, let's rename this artboard to black, and then while we're dragging, press Option Shift to create a copy, and we'll title this one Color. First, we'll add a background color. So select the artboard and go over to Fill Color. And I'm going to use a cream color for this example. Select the main text and change the fill color. I'm going to go with a blue. Now we need to adjust the colors on the gradient to match. Select the first color of the gradient and use the eyedropper tool to pull the same color from the main text. Do the same with the second color on the gradient. But then that removed the gradient, so we'll have to go in and change the opacity to the second color to 0%. Select the first color and adjust the opacity to your liking. I'm going to go with somewhere around 65%. And again, you can adjust how tall or short your gradient is by moving the bottom circle up or down. And that's the general idea for how to add color to this. But let's take it one step further. What if instead of a solid color, we wanted to use a linear gradient with two colors? We'll make another copy of our artboard by pressing Shift, Option, and dragging, and we'll rename this one to Gradient. In order to add a gradient to text, you'll remember from earlier that it needs to be a shape. It can't be live text. Select the text and use the keyboard shortcut Command 8 or go to Object, Path, Convert to Path. Now when we click on the fill color, we see the option and we can choose a linear gradient. For the first color, I'm going to use a magenta purple, and for the second, I'll use a blue. Let's also change the artboard background color. Use the eyedropper tool to pull a color from the gradient, but then adjust it because I want it to be a lighter pastel version. And the last step is to change the colors in the reflection. The best way to keep the colors consistent is to copy the hex codes. Select the main text, go into the gradient, select the first color, and copy the hex code. And since this is a reflection, it's now the color on the bottom, so select the second color on the gradient and paste the hex code. Go back to the main text, select the second color, and copy that hex code. Select the secondary text, go into the gradient, and paste the hex code for the other color. You'll always want to go in and adjust the opacity for your reflection depending on the colors you use and the effect you want. So maybe you go in and increase the opacity or lower it. Maybe you want it dark and dramatic, or you want something light and super subtle. So those are three different ways that you can create reflections, whether you're using just black text on white, you're introducing color, or gradients with multiple colors. You can use the same principles for shapes. So as one last example, let's copy and paste this artboard and use the ellipse tool to draw out a circle. Use Shift and Option on your keyboard to create a perfect circle from the middle of the artboard. We'll remove the border and under Fill, switch to a linear gradient. For the first color, I'm using a red, and for the second, I'm using an orange. I'll also change the background to match, so I'll go with a pale yellow. To create a copy of the shape, we'll press Shift, Option, and drag until the new shape snaps to the bottom of the first. Then use the Flip Vertical tool so that the orange is touching the orange, which is how a true reflection would look. Then we'll go into the gradient and select the first color, the red, which is on the bottom, and change the opacity to 0. Select the other color, orange, and adjust the opacity to your liking. I'm using about 64%. Then we'll pull up that second color to create a shorter gradient. You might want to go in and fine-tune the opacity levels so that it fades just like you want it to. And you're done. That's how you would create a reflection on a shape. So I walked you through four different ways for how to create reflections within your designs in Adobe XD. Whether you're using text or shape, it's the same principles. Just make sure that you outline your text whenever you're trying to apply the gradient. If you found this tutorial helpful, give it a like and subscribe for more. Leave a comment down below and let me know which effect was your favorite that you learned and what you'd like to see next. Also, check out one of these videos.